Good morning, my dear students. Today, I will discuss about the Lamiaceae family. Lamiaceae family, previous name is Labiatae. After this, Labiatae family is converted into Lamiaceae family because as per the ICBN rules, end of the suffix of the family is kept as AC. That's why it is a converted into Lamiaceae family. This Lamiaceae family is commonly called as Mint family or Tulasi family. This Tulasi family is Lamiaceae family. Best example for the Lamiaceae family is Tulasi or Mint. Okay, then next I will discuss about the classification of this family. Class is Dicotyledons, subclass is Gramopetalae, series is Bicarpellate, order is Lamiales, family is Lamiaceae. Then I'll discuss about the why this family is kept in particular series of the Bicarpellate and particular order of the Lamiales. Some points are including in the why it is kept in the Bicarpellate series. Three reasons, due to the presence of the three reasons, Lamiaceae family is kept in the Bicarpellate series. That is, first of all, hypogynous flowers. Due to the presence of the hypogynous flowers, then stamens number is equal to the petals number. Stamens number is equal to the petals number, or stamens number is less than the petals number. Okay, these two reasons. Along with these two reasons, another reason also present, that is carpels. Carpels number is 2. 2 carpels number is present. Those carpels are fused. Okay, carpels are 2 in numbering. Those are fused. Due to these three reasons, it is kept in the Bicarpellate. Okay, then why it is kept in Lamiales order? Some reasons are there. Those are the corolla. Corolla having the petals, those petals are bilabiate, bilips, two lips. Those petals are arranged as two lips. Okay, that's why, due to the presence of the two lips. For example, if petals are 4 in numbering, those are 2 plus 2 in arrangement. Two petals are arranged in upper lip, two petals are arranged in lower lip. This structure is appearance like bilabiate or bilip. That's why it is called as bilabiate corolla. Okay, then another reason is flowers are zygomorphic flowers. Okay, zygomorphic flowers, and stamens are didynamous stamens. What is mean by didynamous stamens? Stamens are either 4 in numbering or 6 in numbering. Though how many numbering of the stamens are present? Those stamens are arranged in two heights, two various heights. Those, for example, 4 stamens, in case 4 stamens are present, those 4 stamens arranged in 2 plus 2 arrangement. Two stamens are larger in same height, like this. Okay, two stamens are smaller, those two stamens are equal height. This type of phenomenon is known as didynamous stamens. Okay, then ovary is trilocular ovary. See this. This is trilocular ovary. One chamber, two chamber, third chamber, fourth chamber. In this way, trilocular ovary is present. In each locule, a ovule is present. In each locule, this is locule, this is locule, locule, locule. In entire structure, 4 locules are present. In each locule, a single ovule is present. Okay, these ovules are arranged at axial placentation, like this. This is axial placentation. Due to these reasons, that is corolla arrangement, that is corolla arrangement is bilabiate. Bilabiate means whatever numbering of the corolla, nothing but petals, those petals are arranged as two lips. in upper lips, 2 in lower lips, 2 in numbering. Otherwise, 3 petals are in upper lips, 1 petal is lower lip. That is known as bilabiate coroma. And zygomorphic flower, stamens are diadenomous stamens, means in case 4 stamens are present, 2 stamens are higher, highest height, and 2 stamens are in lowest height. Then ovary is trilocular ovary like this. This trilocular ovary, in this trilocular ovary, each locule has a single ovule. Okay, these entire ovules are arranged in axial placentation. Okay, then as going to the introduction of the family, already I told common name of the family, that is Mint family or Tulasi family. This is Tulasi family. Maximum, most of the Lamiaceae family plants are distributed in Mediterranean regions. Okay, then Mediterranean regions, in this Lamiaceae family, largest genus is Salvia. Largest genus is Salvia plant with 700 species, and genus type is Lamia. Observe this my demonstration. I'll show the flower of Tulasi. Tulasi flower, this is Tulasi flower. Inflorescence of the Tulasi, Asimum sanctum. In this Tulasi flower, I'll show in this demonstration bilabiate corolla and also diadenomous stamens. Once, see this flower. This is flower, okay? Students, look this. I'll show one demonstration about the Tulasi plant flower of bilabiate corolla. Okay, see this flower's keen observation. This flower, in this flowers, we have to observe that this is a single flower. We have to observe the 5 petals here. This is one petal. This is one petal. 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay. Keen observation of this flower. After this observation, we have to observe the 4 petals. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Small slits between these 4 petals. In between the one petal to another petal. These 4 petals are fused together, formed as a lip. Like this. Okay. Then another petal is free. Another petal is free, formed as another lip. Like this, 2 lips are absorbed. This means, this phenomenon is called bilabiate corolla or bilip. In upper lip, 4 petals are present. In lower lip, 1 petal is present. This is bilabiate corolla. Okay, understood? Next, I'll show another phenomenon, that is diadenomous stamens. Diadenomous stamens. Okay, once, see the fresh Tulasi stamens. 4 stamens are here. In this 4 stamens, in this 4 stamens, 2 stamens are in equal height. 2 stamens are larger in equal height. 2 stamens are smaller in lower height. This is diadenomous stamens. Okay?